What's going on, everybody? Welcome to a slightly different video than what we usually do. This is because we might have some news for our channel that might be not the best ones to hear, but they're not as bad as they could be. First of all, a lot of you might have noticed that our views have been down as of late. Because of those views, we can't really sustain our channel anymore. So, we're not closing it, but we're gonna change our content a little because, first of all, both of us had to put a fair amount of money into the channel because if we didn't put the money into the channel, then we would have ended up needing even more time than we already did, which currently, considering that I'm working on two projects, like I'm working as a developer, I have a freelance work, I'm streaming, and there is Game Architects, there is just so much time you can cram in, and the same goes for Wily, so a couple of things are gonna change. And because the views are down, we're having slight trouble paying our editors, because unfortunately, work costs money. Just so you have an idea what we usually go through when we write a video, I'm gonna sum it up really quick. First of all, we have to look for a topic that we want to write about or that we want to make a video about. Usually this takes up to 2 hours for me because I'm fairly horrible at finding topics to write about. After that, the script writing part is done. Everything we usually say in a video is written down word by word. Doing so usually, like I said, takes somewhere between 2 to 4 hours. After this is done, we send it to the other Game Architects member, so for example, I'm gonna send it to Wily and vice versa, for grammar checking, vocabulary checking, and to check whether the sources and the actual script is correct. Once this is done, we get onto the voiceover. The voiceover takes usually another 1.5 to 2 hours per video, so that's roughly 4 hours per week. Once this is done, there's the video footage, which we sometimes outsource, sometimes we don't outsource it, which means then I will record the video footage. After that is done, it goes over to the editors. This is either Kotlol or Tai. Both of the editors usually need around 10 to 12 hours to edit a video. Once the video is done, it gets sent back to us for review, and then we're gonna look for mistakes. Mostly Wily looks for mistakes, and then those mistakes will get fixed, and then it's finally time to upload to YouTube. Every video takes like around 20 hours of work, which we just can't sustain with the way things are going at the moment.
Alright, so why is this even happening? Well, when I looked at it all, it was mostly down to the algorithm. After comparing all kinds of different metrics in YouTube, like the amount of time people watch a video, the amount of subscribers watching, the amount of non-subscribers watching, and all that jazz, the only thing I could find is that YouTube is just recommending our videos less. Basically, out of nowhere, YouTube decided that our views should drop by around 50%. And thanks to that, we just can't make it. We're losing money every month to the editors. And we pay that out of our own pockets. With the current amount of AdSense money, which is the advertising money that we're making off the channel, we're about a third of the way there to pay the editors every month. So we're quite off our target.
So what is gonna change? Well, first of all, we're gonna upload 4 videos a week instead of 2 videos a week. Among those videos, there will be podcasts, glitch showcases, or tutorials. There will be analysis videos, discussion videos, and sometimes I will just rant about random things that I think make sense. I mean, I like ranting, so I like that. Those videos will be a little longer than usual and have a little more minimalistic design, which makes it easier for us to actually push out videos. We don't have to spend 10 hours on one video anymore. Well, they're gonna be longer and it's gonna be more content, so it's basically a win-win situation. It's just not gonna be as scripted anymore.
Now, how can you help out the channel? Well, one thing you could do is become a member or sponsor of the channel. This way you give us $5 a month, of which $150 goes to YouTube and $350 goes to us, and we can use that money to pay our editors and all kinds of other graphics design stuff we need or anything else. Another thing that will certainly help as well is donating during the podcasts, since we will be doing those live. And you can donate through YouTube, and we set all of that up, so that's also an option. But what if you don't want to donate? Well, then you could always just watch our videos, share them, support this transition by just checking out the videos, seeing if you like them and just watch them, because this will help us in the algorithm in general. The more people that watch our videos and the more watch minutes we get, so amount of minutes of our videos being watched, the better it is for us, and the more AdSense we'll get, and the more people will find the channel. Because if this doesn't work, I will be very honest with you now, if just doesn't work, the channel is just gonna quit. It's gonna be the end of it. We can't sustain it. We can't keep making the content. Because even with this change, we'll still have some cost on the editors, and if we just can't pay them, and if it just doesn't work out, then we'll sadly enough have to close it. So now you know what's up and what's gonna happen. I hope you will still all enjoy the content and at least give it a shot, like the new style and everything. And let's hope that we can make it together. And if not, then YouTube kind of ended it all. Thank you for watching. If you want to check out any of our other videos, which is obviously a great thing to do right now, then you can just click any of the annotations on the screen right now, and subscribe and click the bell button. Then you hopefully won't miss anything, unless YouTube kind of screws that up as well.